One of the big images like that I like to think about whenever I'm writing a book is that people are different at different ages. And so for me, it was very interesting to find Walt, you know, at the age where he had just come back from Vietnam. He had just started as a sheriff's deputy. I mean, we're kind of used to Walt being the big dog, being the boss, you know, being the sheriff and all of this. Well, in this particular book, at least in half of it, you know, Walt's just a deputy. He's just a poor deputy in a whole train full of sheriffs, you know, so it kind of makes him kind of the low man on the totem pole in many ways. And so that was interesting for me to, you know, analyze like and enjoy to write like that. But it was also, I think, very revealing, I think, of Walt's character, which was fun. Like that. The other thing is that, you know, this book was different from any of the others simply because it does take place on a train. And so, you know, whenever you're going to do a mystery that takes place on a train, you have to grant homage, you know, to Agatha Christie like that and say thank you to her because she's the one that started it all. But it also gave me a very different kind of environ for the book because my books take place in the American West where there's a vast expanse, you know, it's a large place, like at large vistas and all of this. Whereas in that train, it's a very compact, very, you know, strained, you know, kind of environment for a mystery. And that was fun to write too. Nonetheless, like that, I think Walt, you know, is a world-class detective like that. He's a Hercule Poirot like that. He's a, you know, Sherlock Holmes. You know, he's the same as all of these other great, great detectives. He just happens to live in a very unoccupied place like that. So he doesn't have quite the opportunities of tripping over bodies the way a lot of these other detectives do. So it makes it a little bit more, you know, more difficult for him. Well, it's, you know, it's pervasive just simply because like that. And there's no way to ignore it. I mean, like, say when we got up here this morning in Lyon, it was snowing. Thank you. I brought that all the way from Wyoming for you guys. Like that. But nonetheless, like that, the point being that here in the very technologically advanced, you know, period, you know, for our development, you know, as human beings, we sometimes fool ourselves into thinking that technology and all these things can control like that or mitigate, you know, nature. It doesn't. Like that. Nature has a way of, you know, having its way. And, you know, in many ways, that's one of the things I'm trying to say with the books. I mean, there's a reason why Walt doesn't carry a cell phone, because in Wyoming, they don't work. Like, if you don't have a tower, you know, for the cell phone to get, you know, some kind of a signal from, it's kind of useless. Like, and so that makes for more and better writing, I think. You know, in my opinion, you know, having characters in novels that are just making cell phone calls or typing on their computers is not very compelling. Whereas if they do have to go knock on a door and they have to ask somebody a question or they have to travel to a place, you know, that puts them at peril, like that's much more interesting dramatic conflict for a novelist.